Hello, and welcome to a fun little coding project that I thought up for today. Today we're going to talk about a type of sorting algorithm. So what do sorting algorithms do? Well, they're responsible for designing how to sort things. And today our sorting algorithm is called bubble sort. Now, why it's called bubble sort, I'm not totally sure, but basically the concept of bubble sort is say you have four items, we'll label them 2, 1, 4, and 3. Now, what bubble sort will do in order to sort these items in order from the smallest number to the greatest number is it'll go through and look at each item pair. So it'll start at the first item pair, and if these should be switched, as in if the latter number is smaller than the former number, then they should be switched, right? Because the smaller number should come before the bigger number. So then it'll switch these. And then that'll look like 1, 2, 4, 3. And then it'll go to the next pair, which is now 2 and 4. And what it'll do? Well, these are already set. These don't need to be switched, right? Because 2 is smaller than 4. So then it'll move to the next pair, which is 4 and 3. And since 3 is smaller than 4, yes, it'll switch these. And so the final sort of this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, just like that. And there we have something sorted. However, if our list is a lot longer, say we have say 1,000 items, it won't be able to get it exactly sorted the first try. Okay, so we're in Python here, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to try to just get the bubble sort algorithm working. So we're going to say we're going to create an array, and this array is just the random numbers. So 2. I'm just pressing random numbers here. It doesn't really matter. Great. We have an array, and we're going to try to sort that array. So we'll create a function called bubble sort. And what is this going to take? This is going to take an array, so it kind of work with anything here. And what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to take the length of that array. So we'll store that as n. And then we're going to say, just like in the pseudocode for the index number I in the range length of in the range n, they import. So we're gonna need pygame. What else are we gonna need? We're gonna use the system to close the app. We're gonna need random to test. Yeah, we're gonna need random to generate the initial. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of make a bar graph type thing, and then we're gonna sort the bars. And so we're gonna start with a random heights for all the bars, and that's what we're gonna use random for. And do I need anything else? And if we want to slow it down or not, we're gonna need time, I think. Okay. So let's start by generating a pygame screen. So we'll call this screen, or let's call this width is gonna equal, let's say 800, and height gonna be 600. And then we're gonna say pygame.initialize. Screen equals pygame dot display. Whoops. Display. And all I'm doing here is creating a screen so we can work that we can work with. This would be a tuple width and height. Okay, so now we have a screen variable created. Let's fill the screen. Screen dot fill. Let's just make it white for now, 255, 255, 255. And that's just the RGB color code for filling. And then we'll just create a while loop to get this while true. So I'm just going to grab code over here just so I don't have to keep copying it. Keep writing it down. I mean, this is just looping through all the events that pygame is giving us, and if we press the exit button up in the top right hand corner, it'll quit the game. Okay, my bad. So we're gonna need to update the screen. Actually, before we do that, we're just gonna do pygame.display.update, and that will actually fill our screen white, and then we'll have that while loop, so that'll keep it going. And if we run this, then we should get a little box that is white. Okay, and we can move this around, and now if we press this button, it should close. Okay, and that start to create the opening screen of the little app we're gonna make. So what do we need to do? We need to draw a bunch of bars on the screen. So if we're gonna make a little bar graph type thing, we're gonna say for I in range num bars. So we need to create a num bars variable. That's gonna be the number of bars we're gonna have. We're gonna say that is gonna be, let's start with 10. Yeah. Num bars equals 10. We need to set the x value of each bar, and we need to set the height of each bar. The height is going to be easy. That's going to be random, so let's do that first. Height equals random dot rand int, and since the y equals 0, is that technically at the top, we're going to have to make these negative. So let's do negative 100 to negative 10, and we'll see how this what this gives us. We're going to take so now we need an x value for each bar, and how are we going to do this? So we have I for which is each bar. So we're going to say I times bar width. So we need a bar width. How should we start? Let's start that with 20 maybe. Bar width, just pixels, 20 pixels. Then we're going to need to add some spaces in between. So we're going to need to do that with I also. I times space. What should space be? Let's make that like 5. Space equals 5 pixels. And then we also need, so if we give this now, if we pass this in now, let's create a draw bars function just to efficiently draw a rectangle with the x, the height, and the color. Because we'll use this later too. Def draw bar. X and height, and we'll do color later. This is not really important. We need to game.draw, and we're just going to be a rectangle. It's going to be in the screen. We'll call this, let's just do it black for now. And then we need to pass in the x value, so that's going to be what we gave there. The y value, if our screen, let's just go like 400. And then the bar width and the height that was passed in. And then we don't want any fill there, so we'll then do, how should we do this? That's good for now. So then we'll do draw bar. With the x value and the height value, and then we need to update the screen. I'll do that in here. Update that. Let me get rid of this one. That's not really important. Now, if we run this, we should have a little display of vertical bars. Okay, so now it's way off to the left there. That's not great, so we should really center that. How do we want to do that? What is that going to be? We'll just add that to our x value. And that should be screen width, right, minus the total width of the screen that the bars take up, and divided by 2. All that divided by 2. So this will be plus width minus the number of bars times the bar width. And then we also need to add the spaces too, right? So plus number of bars times space. And then all of this is going to be divided by 2. Now if we load this, that should now have centered. Oh, what did I do? Width is not defined. Oh. If we load this, then we should see that right in the middle there. Is that right? Is this close enough? Whatever. So now we have 10 bars of random heights in the middle, and these we're going to want to bubble sort, and we want to do this visually. And I don't like black and on white there. That's not great. So let's create a color. We'll just do a blue. And that's going to look like RGB 255. 00255. Why do I keep going to insert? Okay. And then I will draw these with the blue color. Okay, and now later when we're doing the running the bubble sort on them, there shouldn't be a parentheses there. When we're running bubble sort on them, we'll change the colors of the ones we're analyzing at that moment. Okay, so now what we really want to do is we want to make a button on the screen, and when you press sort, it'll sort it'll sort the bars. And how do we want to do that? Let's just grab some code from a button I wrote a while ago, because that's not really relevant to here. I'll be right back. Okay, so what I did is from a different project a while ago, I had this button code, and all it takes in is a message it wants to display on the button, the X coordinate, the Y coordinate, the width, the height, and the color when it's just on the screen, the color when you're hovering over it. And I just set a couple things here. So it'll get the position of the mouse, tell whether it's hovering over it or not, and then whether it's being clicked or not, and then if it's being clicked over the button, it'll draw it with the hover color, and it will set this variable sorting to true. So we need to initiate this variable, and I it's global here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna call sorting is gonna equal false, and in our loop here that initializes the game, we're gonna have to say if sorting. So this is if that button has been pressed, we want to break out of this loop, and then we want to call our function bubble sort. And if we go over to Okay, so let's create our function that is bubble sort. Bubble sort. And what is this going to take in? This needs to take in the array that it's going to sort. And all we're going to do here is we're going to pass it in an array of heights of the different bars. So we're not really going to move the bars. We're just going to draw new bars in at the same height. So let's say bars.append the height value that every time we draw a bar, we need to create something up here that is an array or a list to hold the bars. And also we're going to need to that shouldn't be a problem. Okay, so now we're going to do exactly what we did earlier. We're going to say n equals the length of the array that's passed in. We're going to say for I in range n, and this just went over, so I'm just going to skim this, for j in range 0 to n minus 1 minus I, we're going to say let's just do the sorting part first. We're going to say if the array j is greater than the array j plus 1, then we're just going to switch those. And I have this line of code over here, so I'm just going to copy that in. Not make you sit through sorting all that. Where am I? Here. So then it just switches those. And but before we do that, what we really want to do is we want to visualize that changing those bars. So how are we going to do this? We're going to need to loop through each bar and then tell if we're going to draw a new bar there, or with a different color, or if we're going to just keep the bar how it is. So we'll say for k in range the number of bars, we need to take that same x value we had earlier. Where is that? Because this is just going to be exactly drawing like that, except it's going to have a different. Oopsie. It's going to have a different height, so we're not going to use the same draw bar function. Or we are going to use the function. We're just going to not use the same height. So we have that x, and then we're going to say the height is going to equal bars of that k index, right? So we've now appended the height. So we have all the heights, and then we're going to update the heights and then draw new bars with those heights. And then so we're going to say draw bar with the x and the height. Except we do want to Okay, and then we're gonna, after this, we have to, every time we go through, we have to update pygame.display.update. And we really want to slow this down quite a bit, so I'm going to sleep in between here. Sleep. Let's just sleep for half a second. And then we're going to need to take that while loop again once all this is done, so that we can exit it at the end without breaking things. So now this should be good. We should now bubble sort that array and then draw new columns in the same places as before, but with the right heights. And we're going to go and we're going to do one step in each iteration every half a second. So what happens if we run this? I never drew that button, did I? So here's in the initial one. We really need to take that button. Button. What was the mess? I'm just gonna. What does it take? It takes the message x, y, width, height, color. So we're gonna say the message is gonna be sort. And then I'll do all the positioning stuff off screen, because that's not really relevant. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I have that button in, and I just made it gray and then slightly darker gray when you hover over it, and then just positioned it there, and that's all that I really did. And I forgot to pass in the array here. What is that? Bars, right? Okay, I made an oopsie. I copied this line. I forgot to change the variable, the index variable here, so instead of I, this should be K. I also added a clock here. I'm not, that's just for error texting, but you can look that up, see what that does in Pygame. It's not really important. And then I filled the screen with white every time, so if a bar is shorter than the bar that was there, it won't, where it's being moved to, it won't just cover over it. It'll actually fill the screen and redraw every bar every time. But I was doing this, and now if I run here and I press sort, bam, it's sorted, except that was really fast. You can see it worked, though. It all did is take an array of heights and then go through, and every time it updates the heights, it'll draw the new set of bars until the array of heights are in order, just like in the other function. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to visualize which bars are switching when most easily. And I think the best way to do this is actually in here. Right here, we're going to say if the bars that we're looking at right now, if that bar is a bar that's being updated, if it's actually that value, or bars, not even value, but that object, is bars j plus 1, was it, that's being updated down here? Yeah. Okay. Then we're going to say color equals, what's an orange color? We need a lot of red. Oh, a tuple. Need a lot of red. Need a lot of red. Let's say some green and less blue. That should be about orange, right? And then we're going to say else the color is going to equal blue. What am I doing? I'm not writing this language. Else the color equals blue. So that should work. And we also need to be able to pass in a color here. And we need to accept that here. The color, and instead of blue, this needs to be a variable color. And down here where we're drawing bars, we're also going to pass in blue, which I made a global variable up top. Nice. Okay. So now, if we run this and we sort it, now we should see the orange go back really, really fast, a bunch of times, until it's sorted. Okay, but that wasn't helpful either. So what we're going to do is we're going to greatly up the time that is in between each flip, and we're going to see how it's being updated each time. So I'll run this. So now it's going to wait for 1 second after I press sort, 1 second every time it flips a value. So those should be flipped. Should be flipped. Flip those. Don't flip those. Flip those. Flip those. flip those. I don't know about those. And flip those. So now we can see the smallest value is now at the end. And it's going to go through, and if the value on the right is bigger than the value on the left, it's going to flip them. And so now the last two values are correct. So it should only go up to the third to last value, which it does. And it flipped them. Now the last three values are correct. So we can see it working through all of those nicely. And I'll leave this up just so you can, for a couple of seconds, just so you can kind of look at it and get the gist of visualizing what it's doing. Okay, so I made all these variables variable up top here. So what happens if we up the bars to 100? We'll need to lower the bar width. Let's make that 5, and the space will be 1. And now this should draw a bunch of bars and then sort them, and it will speed it up a little bit because this will take forever. Let's do 1 millisecond there. And if we run this and then sort it, you'll see it go faster over a larger data set. So bam, and that last value. And if you watch this, it's really quite cool actually, because you can see it sorting from the back up. But we can also see why this is really inefficient, right? This technically has to go through this in the number of iterations that is the number, we'll call that n, remember the length of the array, n squared, right? And you can see why that is. It has to go through it n times to sort each one into its correct place. Now, some of them might already be sorted, but in order to be sure, it has to go through it at least n times to make sure all of them are in place, and then it has to go through up to n times for each one, because it has to know whether to switch them or not. Now, it doesn't, because we subtract on the end here, and you can see it's speeding up, and now it's done, and now it is nicely sorted. But you can see that it stops and only goes to a certain point on the end there every time. But in theory, you could have up to going through it n times and then n times for each one, and that gives an iteration of n squared, which is pretty inefficient for a sorting algorithm. Now, for that reason, bubble sort is not really used that much. There are other sorting algorithms, the fastest of which can get up to a number of iterations that is n times the log base 2, I think, of n, where n is, again, the length of the data set that you're sorting. And that's the fastest that I can get. And those are merge sort or tim sort. And there are other ones too. I think I'll do another couple more little coding tidbits on different types of sorting. I'll go through insertion sort and selection sort, which are n squared. And then I'll start going through merge sort and stuff like that, which are more efficient sorting algorithms. So I hope you enjoyed this little fun little coding project. And I'll see you in the next one.